All right, Andrew, you ready for this trailer?
Let's watch it. What's the Miami's like? This is what Florida's like, can't confirm. We do have to wrestle alligators anytime we go outside.
Oh, look at that.
Dude, I fought two gators on my way over to your house today. Lucia and this unnamed male. And it looks like we're going to be playing as both of them throughout. Because that's a, I don't know if you know this, but that's a factor of Grand Theft Auto 5. I'm going to get it either way because Grand Theft Auto 5 is like one of my top five favorite video games of all time.
Yeah.
I was probably too young to be playing GTA Vice City when I was playing it. I'm so excited, dude. I'm telling you, they're going to push the boundaries.
Welcome to Backseat Directing,
where we talk about movies, TV shows, comics, and more.
Like video games. Exactly. We're your hosts,
Andrew
and Aaron.
We put out new episodes every Monday and Thursday.
And on this episode, we're reacting to the GTA 6 trailer.
3, 2, 1.
Action. In my head, I was like, is it 5 or 6? Is it 5 or 6? Is it 5 or 6? I got it right. 6.
Nice. You nailed it, my friend.
Thank you.
So this is actually the 8th installment of main GTA games in the franchise, which is awesome. These games go way back. Like, when I was a kid, I was playing, the earliest I think was on PlayStation 2, but there's even PS1 GTA games. So I the first game I remember playing is Vice City, and then I played San Andreas. And those are among two of like the higher viewed games, along with Grand Theft Auto 4 and 5, which Grand Theft Auto 5 came out in 2013, which I was a freshman in high school. Jeez, when this game came out, just to date myself there.
What, 11 years?
That's yeah, crazy. Almost. Well, it'll be 12 years because the next game's coming out in 2025.
GTA. Oh my gosh.
So they took 12 years, but in that whole time, they put out the GTA Online, and they've been continuously updating that the whole time.
Mm-hmm.
So on top of that, they also made Red Dead Redemption 2. But they have continuously been updating GTA Online so that people who play Grand Theft Auto can still have like new things. There's new, they not just updating it in terms of like maybe new cars and guns, which they also do, but they put in like new missions so that it's like you have a new gaming experience and missions you can go and plan heists with your friends and do them online. So
that's people, pretty cool. It's like life,
yeah,
in a sense.
Yeah,
you know, like new tasks come up,
exactly,
new jobs arrive, you know,
and people have been enjoying GTA Online the whole time. Like, tons of people are still on those servers. So,
oh yeah, absolutely. So I was pretty sheltered as a kid, so I actually have never played GTA.
I was probably too young to be playing GTA Vice City when I was playing it, but
yeah, probably if you were playing some of the earlier versions and the newest one came out when you were a freshman in high school.
Dude, there is this great bit that the guy Tony Stucci, or however you say his name, he's a really big TikToker, and he's like the GameStop employee selling you out when you try to buy a new Grand Theft Auto game with your mom. And he's like, yeah, I just need you to approve this game for your son. It has murder, drugs, sinning, murder. She's like, murder twice? He's like, yeah, there's that much murder. And she's like looking at her son. She's like, what are you into? I remember having to get parents' permission to buy Grand Theft Auto and Call of Duty and stuff back in the day. That's
so
funny.
And now you just buy it online.
Now I'm an adult.
That's right.
Yeah, now kids are probably buying it online.
Easy.
Just put in a different age on their PlayStation account when they set it up.
So I don't play a ton of video games, but every once in a while I get hooked, you know, and I just go on this rampage, you know, and hurry through a game because it's so good. And today we're going to watch the trailer to GTA 6, and I'm watching it to see like, oh, is this something that I want to dive into or not?
I'm going to get it either way because Grand Theft Auto 5 is like one of my top five favorite video games of all time.
Okay, here comes Andrew's top whatever list.
It's my top five.
Every single thing we talk about Grand is Theft Auto in this 5. Top 10.
My top
5.
My top 5 video games of all time.
We actually have a list this time.
I'll go.
Okay, let's hear it.
I'll go Batman Arkham Knight, okay. Batman Arkham City, Grand Theft Auto 5, The Last of Us Part 1, Last of Us Part 2. Oh, crap, The Binding of Isaac. Yeah, I'll stick with that 5 for now.
No Spider-Man?
No Spider-Man.
Okay, nice.
The Last of Us pushed Spider-Man out when I played those games.
All right, before we get into the trailer, which we're going to do here in just a minute, I want to say thank you for watching. We post new episodes, like Andrew said in the intro, every Monday and Thursday. And I'd like to invite you to something very special, and that is hitting that subscribe button.
Oh, yeah. You should do that. That's he doesn't invite everybody to that.
Yeah. No, only the viewers of this episode.
So. So if you want to take advantage of this limited time exclusive offer, yeah. And if you call in the next 10 minutes, you can get $19.95.
For three easy payments. All right, Andrew, you ready for this trailer?
Let's watch it.
All right, here we go. We are live.
Lucia. Do you know why you're here?
Oh, bad luck, I guess.
Made perfect. So this is all going to be on her back. Also heard that this is in Vice City, which is like the stand-in for our world's Miami. So that's why you see all this beachfront, this water. Yeah, we live in Florida.
We live here.
We love Florida. We like
Florida. We're a little way away.
Yeah, well, like 4 hours or something. Pretty good. It's like sand. That's what Miami's like? This is what Florida's like. Can't confirm. We do have to wrestle alligators anytime we go outside.
Oh, look at that.
Dude, I fought two gators on my way over to your house today.
It's dangerous out there.
Mudding, yeah, that's very Floridian.
Look who's back. The only way we're going to get
drinking, also very Floridian,
is by sticking together.
Comics, classic Florida. So, I believe it's our main characters are
Trust,
Lucia, and this unnamed male. And it looks like we're going to be playing as both of them throughout, because that's a, I don't know if you know this, but that's a factor of Grand Theft Auto 5, is you switch between three characters.
Okay.
Trevor, Franklin, and Michael, you switch between those three characters. And from what I can tell, there's no outright statement about when in 2025. I heard that Take-Two, the company that owns Rockstar, apparently implied that it would be in or before March of 2025. So yeah. It's like, if it's in the first third of the year,
it's kind of amazing. Like us with our short film.
It's coming.
It's coming.
What did we say we were going to put on a t-shirt? Is it like, it's coming out eventually or something like that? For the, yeah, for the because D&D of the D&D. D&D.
Yeah. That's just how it works sometimes, you know, like when you're making final touches to a project, sometimes it takes a little long. So you've played the games. What'd you think?
I mean, it looks stunning. Like it's every time they put out a new Grand Theft Auto game, like they add to the visuals, which... You got to think how exponentially more difficult it is for them than other studios when their maps are like the biggest and you can do the most things in their games. Like, I would challenge you to find a game where you can really do more things. Apparently in this...
With the environment specifically.
I mean, in Grand Theft Auto 5, it's not just that they have a humongous open world. It's also that you can drive everywhere. You can ride a dirt bike. You can parachute. You can fly a plane. There's so many mechanics and just so many regions that to fine tune the details on all these buildings to deserts to mountaintops, like it is insane the amount of hours of work that Rockstar puts into these games. Like it is second to none. And then when it comes to Red Dead Redemption 2, the size of that map is like one of the biggest we've seen. I think Breath of the Wild is bigger, but like the Zelda games are huge maps, but they're also a completely different animation style. They have the benefit of that like more cartoonish animation that fits into their world, whereas like Grand Theft Auto has more realistic style.
Yeah.
And it's just, they put so much into it. Red Dead 2 is like one of the best games ever. It has an incredible story, and it's just like these beautiful different biomes of like swamps to snowy mountains, waterfalls, forests, all different kinds of animals. Like in this game, I've already heard that you're going to be able to have mini games of like playing basketball, surfing, working out and going to the gym, which I'm sure you'll love.
But what's like, better than working out in person? Working out online.
Working out in Grand Theft Auto. But it's just so, it looks amazing. It looks like they, like I said, they make it better every time. There's more detail into the characters and the environment. The sandy beaches of Vice City look awesome. I think it's called like Leonida or something, their version of Florida.
Yeah.
But they're obviously also like poking fun at making like
Florida, man.
Yeah. Which we get all the time.
It was, like it's our state. Miami. It was very Miami.
But it's, everyone in bathing suits, everyone like glossy and fit, you know. What did you think from the outside perspective?
Yeah. So as someone who has, I've never played the game. I guess I've played it once, but it was kind of just messing around, you know. But like that was it. So
that's what most people do though in Grand Theft Auto is they play and they come in and mess around.
Yeah.
I think that's the average experience.
Right. And I don't know if I like games like that because I'm more of like a mission guy.
No, but there's a great story in GTA 5. This relationship between these three characters.
I haven't experienced any of that. So with this, I feel like it didn't give me much as a new player to the game. You know, like we didn't get to see any gameplay. I don't really know what the story is about. It was kind of more of like a visual showcase.
Yeah, I heard they dropped it early. There was apparently rumors of a leak that somebody was going to leak the trailer, so they kind of dropped it earlier than anticipated.
Okay, interesting.
Might have even, from what I read, might have even just been a day early, but still.
Yeah.
Interesting that that were to happen.
Yeah, so I see as a fan who has already played, especially if you've been playing for a decade or more, like, yeah, I can see how you're excited. But for me, as someone who's never played before, it didn't really give me much. You know, like, I don't really know what I'm in for, you know, and I don't know. That didn't make me any more excited than I was before watching it. But that's because I don't know the game, you know, like, you know, the game style. So like you see that and you're like, oh, like I get to do that. You hear all these rumors and you're like, oh, I get to do this and fly this and drive this. You know, like I can see how people would be excited for this.
I'm excited for the concept too, because this Lucia and her like unnamed male counterpart are supposed to be like a Bonnie and Clyde kind of story. They're like a couple committing these crimes together. So I'm excited for the relationship dynamic. Are they going to be loyal to each other? Are they going to trust each other? Are they going to deserve each other's trust? Like, plus considering we'll be playing as both of them, like, will we harm one another? Will we like betray one another and then experience that betrayal from both sides? There's just so many aspects to playing as different characters in one game. Which is right. Like The Last of Us 2 gives that. Which, so like, I'm very excited to see that. And like, I know that they're masters at Rockstar of like creating this open world experience. They make such an awesome open world experience and tell great stories. Like I said, Red Dead Redemption 2, such a cool enthralling story with like twists and turns and like this relationship between all these people in the gang. They also create great side characters. Like Lester in Grand Theft Auto 5 is a great character. But I think you can trust their storytelling chops. In Grand Theft Auto 5, it was like, Michael and Trevor were on a bank heist gone wrong. And then Franklin is like this new guy that Michael's kind of mentoring. And then like the three of their stories kind of clash together. And there's like these past grievances between Michael and Trevor. So there's all these like complicating factors while you're trying to plan new heists. Mm-hmm. And then it's so satisfying in the game to watch your money go up. Because like with each heist, you get like more and more dollar value on the bigger heist as you go along.
It's like a more high stakes version of Monopoly.
Like a criminal high stakes version of Monopoly. Yeah. But let's not act like these big landlords aren't criminals too in Monopoly. Right. Charging the rent that they do.
Ridiculous.
Heinous.
Unacceptable.
Once I have a hotel on Park Place,
fight that's justice.
Highway robbery. But yeah, I'm super, I mean, just hearing the name that Grand Theft Auto 6 is coming out is exciting for me. But the title of this video, I must have played the next video.
Yeah.
But just hearing that it's coming out is exciting enough. So like you said, it's a different experience. As a fan of the games already, when you see the trailer open up, you're like just looking for the environments and the changes in the animation. You're like, oh, white sand beaches, this awesome coastal city. Like we're in Leonida, we're in Vice City. You're just looking at that. You're like, that's where I'm going to be playing. I'm going to be driving down these streets. You know, you know what the gameplay is going to feel like. I'm sure they're going to enhance the driving. I heard they put more like polygons in the animation on the vehicle so that the vehicle destruction will be more accurate and detailed. So they're just adding, like they do not understand the meaning of half-assing at Rockstar. I'm telling you.
Sounds like my kind of company.
They put so much effort into it. And then like from Bully to Red Dead Redemption to Grand Theft Auto 5, they like are always looking for ways to like change and push the envelope. And they don't just put out the next game twice. That's why there's 10 years in between, you know? Because this is going to be a whole new world of gaming.
Yeah, and this game has to be baller, right? Coming out 12 years after the last one.
There's a lot of anticipation.
Yeah. That's a high bar to live up to, you know?
Like, I hate how early we get told about video games specifically, though. Because now...
Well, that's what happened with Spider-Man 2 as years. Well. Like,
yeah.
Or Wolverine as well. Like, are they even still working on that? They announced it forever ago.
We just got a Blade game announced as well. There's a teaser trailer for that. I don't know if you saw.
No, I haven't.
It's a nothing teaser trailer. It shows nothing.
Because they have nothing yet, you know?
They just have the name.
Right.
But yeah, I'm super pumped. There was a lot of backlash too for Lucia, actually. I don't know if you've heard this, but a lot of people upset that the main character, they have you playing as a woman, which like, don't know why people hate women, but it's like half the earth. It's a lot of energy.
It's a lot of it. True. Yeah, I didn't think anything of that.
Yeah, I mean, it'll be cool to get like another perspective, because this is a relationship perspective.
Yeah.
Versus GTA 5, it was like they were all like there was tension, partners. But they were partners and friends.
Yeah. Interesting. I'll dabble. I'll see what it's like. You know.
You'll play when I buy it, and then see if you want to buy.
Exactly.
I'm definitely getting this game. I'd pay more than $70 for this game.
Careful.
I would pay a reasonable amount for this game.
There we go. You don't want to like invite it high, you know? Like, oh, I'd pay $120. And they're like, bet.
But like, you can get so many hours of playtime out of any of the GTA games.
Yeah.
Like, and then when they make it bigger and better each time, you're gonna be able to get so much time out of GTA 6. Even especially when they put the online on afterwards, you can get hundreds of hours of playtime out of these games.
Yeah. There's very few games that I've played for hundreds of hours.
Well, they let you choose the route of the heist too. So like GTA 5, I played through it twice, because you can choose like a more stealthy option to the heist or like a big guns blazing option. So like I replayed the game and tried heists in different ways that I thought would be fun. Like, so that adds a layer. If you can plan heists and do them different ways in this game too, like there's so much more playtime right there.
Yeah, for sure. It seems cool in concept.
Yeah, isn't it cool? You get to plan a heist, so you pick a route. Like, you get a blueprint, you can pick a route, and then you go along and do the preparation for the heist. Like, in GTA 5, you would, like, go and steal an armored car so that you could have it for the heist, and then you take it to a body shop and get it done up for, like, all this, like, detailed stuff. It's like you're actually doing the heist. It's not like you just got dropped into a mission, and they're like, objective, get the money.
Isn't it crazy how they can make all this stuff, like, you do this and this happens? Like, the cause and effect in video games is crazy. I feel like normal people like us can't even comprehend the amount of stuff that goes into
the
that
computations, like, they're putting into these games.
Yeah, like making a movie where there's only one cause and effect is really hard to do, and there's hundreds of causes and effects within a video game. It's wild that this is even possible.
Yeah, I'm so excited, dude. They're gonna push the boundaries. They're gonna make something super special and unique. GTA 5 is an all-time great game.
Game of the year?
Probably. Oh no, okay. I thought you were talking about GTA 5. GTA 6 probably game of the year 2025. Yeah. It's gonna be hard to beat.
Yeah.
Red Dead Redemption 2 was game of the year. Red Dead Redemption 2 was game of the year. I think it beat out some like other really great games that year too.
All right. Any closing thoughts for GTA 6 trailer reaction here?
Make sure to let us know in the comments what you think about the GTA trailer. What aspects are you most excited for? What are you against? Do you hate Lucia, even though we don't know her yet? Just tell us what you think.
Careful.
And we'll chat with you in the comments and share our opinions too.
Yeah, thanks so much for watching the show. Again, we post new episodes twice a week, every Monday and Thursday, sometimes even more. So make sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of our content. Be sure to share our show with a friend, because that's how we grow and get more people into this community. Again, we have a Discord and the link in the description where you can chat in more detail about different topics, movies, games, TV shows, comics. And then we also, in that, put in like episode updates, like what we're planning on filming and all that stuff. And then we take suggestions as well for any topics that you want us to cover. We do movie reviews, game reviews, comics, shows. We do a bunch of debates. Those are a lot of fun to do, different drafts. So we try to have a wide variety of stuff to attract a bunch of people and to just enjoy all this content that we get to consume. So thanks so much for watching, and
that's a wrap. We'll be right back.